sculpture as therapy.
I did a series called Addiction a couple of years ago that involved small pieces of figures who wear striped suits and bags over their heads. The bags represent fearlessness, not facing reality, being out of control, shame.
Meet Grace and Mark, parents of Robbie, a 26-year-old heroin addict who started drinking and smoking marijuana as a teen and quickly moved on to other drugs.
Crystal meth, crack cocaine, cocaine, drugs like ecstasy, LSD.
And some we've not even heard of.
Grace's artwork reflects their struggles over the past dozen years.
The parent tries to fix the child. The child grows dependent on being fixed. And therefore, the parent and the child both are held prisoner in that circle.
To deal with his drug abuse, they tried just about everything. They sent him to boarding school in Utah. After that, it was college in North Carolina. But he flunked out after one semester. His parents decided to move him back closer to home, to Georgia.
This is the Atlanta neighborhood where Grace and Mark tried to give their troubled son a fresh start. They rented him an apartment. He promised to get a job. But they say he didn't hold up his end of the deal. He didn't get a job, and the apartment became deplorable. Obscene graffiti written on the walls, dog feces on the bed, and drug dealers who'd moved in. There was no longer any doubt their son was an addict. So they made the tough love decision and cut him off.
Robbie wound up on the streets, homeless. He moved around, living at various times in Miami, New Orleans, and Chattanooga, where he broke his back, jumping off a bridge after a night of heavy drinking. Over 4 years, his parents still had to step in and rescue Robbie after each episode. Their stress and anger drove them to a group called Families Anonymous for help.
When I go to these meetings, I know that that support system is there and that it's powerful.
The group offers a 12-step program for families of addicts and persuaded them to relax the permanent safety net that they'd created for Robbie.
No question, we hope the best for him, and we love him and want him to have a happy, productive life, and hopefully he will.
But whether he does or not is up to him. It's his choice.
The last call Mark and Grace got from Robbie came after 4 months of hearing nothing from him.
Our son is currently in New Orleans.
He told them he wanted to go into detox again. This time, they told him how to help himself.
We gave him numbers to call to arrange detox, and we also assisted with that.
After 4 days, Robbie left detox.
We assume he is back on the street.
Through Families Anonymous, Mark and Grace say they've learned it's okay to take care of themselves.
This last year or two, we've experienced more joy because our consciences are clear.
As seen in Grace's artwork.
One of the pieces is called Recovery, and it's a smiling face with bags that hang down from it, as if the baggage has been left behind.
Julie Peterson, CNN.